One recent regulatory development that we've seen within the EU has been the introduction of the AIFMD, the Alternative Investment Fund Managers Directive, which essentially changed the ball game in a massive way, I would say.
So Joseph, the regulatory reforms in Switzerland are impacting thousands of fiduciary operations based in Switzerland that are not FEMA licensed. Does Malta's regulatory framework offer any opportunities to such operations?
Well, undoubtedly, as you said yourself, there is a reform going on in Switzerland. Now, reforms and new regulations have been hitting the market, whether EU-wide, globally, if you like, as well, and even in Switzerland. Effectively, what we're currently seeing in Switzerland is a reform that will impact fund managers as we have known them to be for many years. Currently, the scenario here in Switzerland is essentially, the way I see it, is split into two categories. You have the FINMA-regulated operators, and you have the rest of them, hundreds if not thousands of them, that are members of self-regulatory organizations. And this regulatory reform that is basically on the table at the moment will predominantly impact these latter ones, the unregulated fund managers. And as I said, there are hundreds or thousands of them. Now, in our view, the business model that has been adopted so far by many fund managers, whether regulated or unregulated in Switzerland, has to change in order to obviously address the implications of the new regulations. Like any other regulation, this brings challenges as well as opportunities, obviously. Now, the ones who gear themselves up in good time would be better placed in order to ensure that they exploit the features of the reform, of the new regulations, and essentially position themselves in such a situation that they turn the challenge into a real opportunity. And I believe that Malta has a good business case to put on the table for these latter ones. With respect to the FINMA-regulated entities, as my understanding is, there we're seeing a consolidation of operations. There are the big players who are already well-established and well-geared to take on the onset of the new obligations coming out of the directive. There are the smaller ones who are consolidating themselves and perhaps even merging. But on the other hand, the unregulated entities will need to change their business model. Now, in Malta, we do have a regulation which essentially caters for the requirements of small-time fund managers, be they private individuals or asset management companies that are unregulated.
What are the latest regulatory reforms in Malta, and how is it impacting Malta's position in the EU as a fund domicile?
Okay. The way I see it is that Malta, when it entered the fund industry, which does not go back many decades, I mean, we have been as a domicile in the fund industry as players for the past 20, 25 years, the first half of which was, I would say, characterized by an inward-looking scenario in that we had local players, local banks, structuring funds in Malta for local consumption. So there was no international flavor in it. That came about around 12 years ago, 13 years ago, when Malta positioned itself at the time as an ideal jurisdiction to attract small and medium-sized fund managers. And Malta has been very successful in that, in view that I would say that the fund industry in Malta has been created thanks to that particular segment. But it has always been Malta's way to ensure that it does not rest on its laurels, but ensure that it keeps a pace with regulatory developments in order to reinvent itself, to position itself, to exploit opportunities that new regulations bring to the fore. One recent regulatory development that we've seen within the EU has been the introduction of the AIFMD, the Alternative Investment Fund Managers Directive, which essentially changed the ball game in a massive way, I would say. Now, what Malta did in order to ensure that it remains relevant and stays in the game is that all the operators locally, including the regulator in Malta, there was a concerted effort in better comprehending the regulation, its implications, and ensuring that all players are sufficiently geared in order to take on the challenges that the new regulation, some of them very onerous, would bring about. So in my opinion, if I were to pin down the one single regulatory development that could be a game changer for Malta, it is precisely this particular area of notified alternative investment funds.
Well, thank you, Joseph, for speaking to us today about these reforms.
Thank you so much. Thank you.